will you just tell us, what is biochar?
All right, so biochar is charcoal that is intentionally added to the soil to achieve some benefit. It's more similar to compost than different, but here are the key differences. One, when biochar comes out of the pyrolysis facility, that's where they heat it up under low oxygen, it typically has really low nitrogen content, whereas a good compost will have a pretty good balanced nitrogen content. It also has really large chains and sheets of 6 carbon rings, which make it really impervious to decomposition. Like most microbes, fungi, they don't have the ability to break down biochar like they do compost. So when you add it to the soil, it's gonna be there more or less permanently. It has a really long half-life of decades to centuries.
Yeah, at least for the gardener's entire life.
Yeah. From a human perspective, it's a permanent soil amendment. It has some other interesting properties. It has a lot of ion exchange capacity. So that's useful for nutrient retention. Can also be helpful for things like salt remediation in soil or remediating heavy metals and organic contaminants and that kind of thing. If you're looking at more like brownfields and land reclamation purposes. Also, those layers of aromatic carbon, they repel each other very strongly. So because of that, if you get enough biochar in the soil, it'll be fairly resilient to compaction. It's not going to cement together and turn to concrete like some of our soils do. So there'll always be little channels and things for roots to get through and reestablish themselves. It is natural. So with forest fires, prairie fires that would historically be part of the landscape, they accumulated large amounts of pyrogenic carbon, which is the same thing as biochar. Over thousands of years, both natural fires, fires that Native Americans set. That's one reason the soils of the Midwest are so fertile, is they have a high proportion of these pyrogenic carbon compounds. So it is something natural that we're trying to replicate.